In this short video, let us see how to generate the 90 degree phase shift between the two digital signals using the flip-flops. So as you know, if we connect the Q bar output of the D flip-flop back to the input side, and if we observe the output, then it is changing between the 1 and 0 continuously at the every clock pulse. And this is how the output will look like. And if we see the Q bar output, then it is 180 degree phase shifted with respect to the Q output. But now let us see, by modifying this circuit, how we can generate the two signals which are 90 degree phase shifted with respect to each other. So for that, we need the another flip-flop. But in this case, the second flip-flop should be the negative edge triggered flip-flop. And the output of the first flip-flop should be connected to the input of the second flip-flop. So with this arrangement, it is possible to generate the second signal which is 90 degree phase shifted with respect to first signal. So now let us see how it will work. So here, this is the clock signal. And as I said, when we connect the Q bar output of the D flip-flop back to the input side, then the output will toggle at the every clock edge. So here, this Q1 output will toggle at the every rising edge. And now this output is connected as an input to the second flip-flop. But now, since the second flip-flop is the negative edge triggered flip-flop, so it will respond to this output at the falling edge. That means here if you observe, then at the first falling edge, this Q1 output is equal to 1. Therefore, this Q2 output will also go high. And now, if you see at the second falling edge, then this Q1 output is equal to low. That means now, this Q2 output will also become low. That means in this way, the second flip-flop will follow the first flip-flop at the every falling edge. And in this way, it is possible to generate the 90 degree phase shift, provided the duty cycle of the clock signal is equal to 50%. So if that is the case, then this Q1 and Q2 will be phase shifted with respect to each other by the 90 degree. So now, instead of a negative edge triggered flip-flop, suppose we have a positive edge triggered flip-flop, then in that case, we need to apply the clock signal to the second flip-flop via the inverter. And here, we are assuming that the delay of this inverter is negligible. So in this way, it is possible to generate the two signals which are 90 degree phase shifted with respect to each other. Apart from this, using a 2-bit twisted ring counter or using the 2-bit Johnson counter also, it is possible to generate the two signals which are 90 degree phase shifted with respect to each other. Because as you know, the n-bit Johnson counter has the two end states. And here if you observe, then the each output of the flip-flop is phase shifted from each other by 360 divided by 2n degree. So for example, if we have a 2-bit Johnson counter, then the outputs are phase shifted from each other by the 90 degree. On the other hand, if we have a 4-bit Johnson counter, then the each flip-flop in this Johnson counter is phase shifted from each other by the 45 degree. And in this way, using these simple circuits, it is possible to generate the different phase shifted digital signals. So for more information about this Johnson counter, you can check this video.